So today's video is actually going to be on something I find to be amazing, very helpful for me, and it was all free. I'm going to teach you how to make a 2D anime looking VTuber VRoid model without using Live2D. There's no need for expensive commissioning for anyone to rig a model or create a model for you or to be on some Twitter waitlist or even to rig it up. And as I said, it's free. So some people are going to love this idea and some people are going to probably hate me for it. That's fine though. This video is simply for those of you out there who do not have the money yet to pay or commission someone else to make you a live 2D model VTuber. You do not need any money for this. I had you in mind when I came up with this video idea, and I hope that this enables you to start. If you like this video and the value that I'm bringing to you, please hit that bell and subscribe. So here we go. So here I will change the textures of a few areas to make her 3D features into 2D looking ones. So let's say we have a VRoid model that we've created. So let's start with hair. We'll go to texture. And as you can see here, this texture is very much for the 3D model and it looks like 3D hair more so than drawn hair or anime hair. But when I change the base color here and I change the shade color, we'll add the texture that is for our 2D model. And you can see that there is a drastic change in how the hair looks. It no longer has that 3D feel to it, but a drawn anime 2D feel to it. So we will now go to face editor. And we're gonna mess with some of the textures here as well. We're gonna leave the mouth alone and the eye line. We're gonna go down to the irises, but we're going to import completely 2D eyes. And you can see the difference. Then we're going to change the eye highlights here by adding a layer, importing our eye highlights. Thank you to Argama for the skin that we are about to use. I'm very grateful for her leaving those as free, which you can download. So here we're just going to add a layer and we're going to import the anime face skin. This one is called Pale that I'm using, and you can use the same as well. As I said, the links will be in the description, and this skin is by Argama Witch, which is perfect for us and free at the moment. So when we add the face skin, I have also created a blushy as well, and I do this in another program, but we're just gonna add her little blushy because I like blushy. Then we're gonna go to the body. And we're going to change the texture using the texture by Argama Witch as well. So we're just gonna add a layer. Okay, then we're gonna import. And as you can see, the skin immediately becomes more flattened with some shading. What we're gonna do also, and I will have another video on this, is we're going to change the texture of the clothes. So here, I'm going to add another layer. You can name your layers by using rename. This is top anime layer 2D version. And you can see that there is a very big difference in the shirt quality. So we're just going to do that to the skirt as well. And we're going to add another layer. Again, you can rename these later. And I have found a method to make the skirt look flat and drawn and more anime looking as well. If you'd like to see the video that refers to how to make your clothes look 2D versus 3D, please subscribe and I will be making that video shortly. For the sneakers as well, I have changed these sneakers into some very flat anime 2D looking sneakers that just kind of look drawn on there. So at the end, we have our model getting very close to looking like a 2D model. Now, what I do generally with an editor is in the outline, I will raise the outline width to its utmost for all of these. This gives it literally a body outline, which from here looks black, but you can change the color of the outline to anything you want. Then I generally will lower the rim lights on those. And now she's looking very, very different than how she originally started. And we will give her a pose. As you can see, she's moving without being rigged. It is just for the purposes of this video. And then we would click export. As you can see, she's coming together. And as you can see here by my little slideshow, there is a very big difference, and you can have both. I hope this video was helpful for you and also saves you money as well as saves you time. I was lucky in finding the creator's content, and I decided to share it with you, my community, and my friends. We have a free VTuber assets section where you can download these VRoid assets. Links are in the description and on my Discord. If you like this video and the value that I'm bringing to you, please hit that bell and subscribe.
And 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and action.
Keep clicking start streaming. Okay, and action. Today's video is going to be on something I find to be amazing, very helpful for me, and best of all, it was free. All I needed to do was, okay, one more time.